Hi everyone! I didn't have anything else to do today, so we're doing the unpopular opinions book tag because I feel like tags are just fun. And this one I feel like is one of my favorites to watch anyway. I feel like a lot of people were doing it and then it got stale, and then I've just seen a lot of people who are new to booktube doing it now. It was the unpopular opinions book tag, one of my first tags that I ever filmed on my channel. Maybe, but we're not gonna talk about it. Technically I'm doing this again, but all my answers are different, and I think a lot of these answers now are a lot more genuine, just because when I was starting off, I really just said all the answers that I thought people wanted to hear, as stupid as that sounds. So anyway, today we're going to get into the nitty gritty of the things I like, things I don't like. Maybe feelings are gonna get hurt. Honestly, I'm not a critical reader at all. I read for pleasure and fun. So like, negative things are hard for me, but let's get into the questions. I have them on my phone, which refuses to unlock. Question number one, a popular book or series that you didn't like. For this one, I think the most popular one that I didn't like is probably Caraval by Stephanie Garber. I read the first book. I didn't particularly like anything about it. I don't think, it's just not my kind of book. It's really slow. I realized that I don't like atmospheric books if I don't like the characters, if that makes sense. Like, if there's a really strong plot, I can at least go on. You know, just because the plot is driving you forward, even if I don't like the characters, I can keep reading. But if it's like really slow, and if I don't like the characters, then like, what are you giving me? Does that make sense? I didn't like our main character, Scarlett, I think, or Charlotte, maybe her name was. I didn't like the romance. It was like, I think they fell in love at like 5 days. It just wasn't for me. So I unhauled Legendary. I mean, I'm saying I unhauled it. The books are still like, you can see this pile. There's Caraval there. But yeah, I've owned Legendary for a very long time. I recognize I'm not gonna read it. So when I can actually sell books, I will sell them back. Popular book or series that everyone else seems to hate but you love. I'm really mainstream, I feel like. I couldn't think of an answer. But I guess the overwhelming answer is probably Cassandra Clare. You can tell from both these shelves right here. I love me some Cassandra Clare. She's probably the author that has stuck with me since I was really young. In the way that I mean, I read a lot as a kid as well and as a teenager, but I don't read those books anymore. My tastes have changed. The things I like to read about have changed, but I feel like Cassie Clare's books are just such a safe place to land for me. I feel like just because she's been writing about this world for so long, it just feels safe every year coming back to it in a new capacity, exploring a different side of the world, exploring the same part of the world that's just changed with time. I don't know, I feel like her books are just something to look forward to every year for me, and I do think she's gotten a lot smarter with every book that she's written, and I do think she's gotten a lot better for sure. The way her stories interweave and connect with her previous books is just masterful to me. Like, honestly, I don't think, can you imagine writing, what is it, like 16 books in the same world and having them all mesh together, introducing a character in like book 3 and then have them magically show up in book 15 and have that connect? I don't know. I'm super excited for Chain of Iron to come out. I'm even more excited for The Wicked Powers to come out when I'm like, I don't know, 30. I don't know when that's coming out, but I just love Kid and Ty so much, so I'm really looking forward to that one. And she's so consistent. Like, I love that. A lot of people wrote really great books and then they just have not written anything since, but she's just consistently writing. You can tell that she loves to write. She has a Tumblr where she just posts snippets from the book, and like, she's always writing, clearly. So like, I really love her books. Am I saying that her first series is perfect? No, I still don't like it that much, but like I said, her books are just so much fun and the world is just so familiar to me now. So I feel like while she's branching off and writing about different worlds, I definitely don't think she's done with the Shadowhunter world, so like, we will get a lot of books in that world in the future, so I'm excited for those. But I also get all the negativity about her as well. Like, I do get that first series has a lot of problematic elements, but I do think that she, like I said, is getting a lot smarter with every book that she writes. Anyway, okay, this question is just, okay, a love triangle or an OTP where the main character ended up with the character you didn't want her to end up with instead of the character that you want her to end up with. Okay, I feel like, Lord, give me strength. I did not want to bring Stormlight Archive into this, but okay, spoilers, I guess, for the Stormlight Archive. Not really, because this is more just me as a fan projecting what I want in the books. Okay, whatever. But I'll put a timestamp if you just want to skip this entire thing that I'm going to go into, but it's not really spoilers. I don't think relationships are spoilers, but anyway. In an ideal world, if I had written the Stormlight Archive, if I wrote the Stormlight Archive, it would be a garbage fire. But if I got to choose, obviously, I'm pretty sure if a lot of us got to choose, we would want a OT3, we would want Kaladin, Shallan, and Adolin to be together forever and ever and ever, because they're perfect, all three of them. They need each other. Like, you can't make me choose two out of the three. Like, I would hate to do that. But if I did, it wouldn't be Adolin. I'm sorry. I feel like I'm getting ready to like fight, but okay. I never felt that much of a connection to, I mean, I love Adolin. I love him so much. He's such an important character in the Stormlight Archive just because everyone else is like down in the dirt and like they have so much trauma to deal with. And Adolin is just this happy little cinnamon sunshine boy. I don't know how to say this, but like obviously if I got my pick, I would without any doubt say that I want a polyamorous relationship between the three of them. But if I didn't, I wouldn't pick Shallan and Adolin. I think they're so special. Like, I love their bond. I know how much Shallan needs him the same way Kaladin needs him. So like, what are you doing, Sanderson? Like, why? So basically this is all Kaladin's fault because he just had to go and be a prude. But I don't know why. Like, why? Kaladin, just get with the program. I never really shipped Shallan and Adolin. I feel like they're very cute together. If they end up together, I mean, I will be fine with it. But after Words of Radiance, I had a hardcore Shallan and Kaladin phase. So much so that Katie from Brightness, Katie Reads, who I just met like the day before, I like hounded her on her DMs being like, please tell me if they end up together. I don't have my copy of Oathbringer yet. And somehow she's still friends with me. Let me just show you another. Yeah, I don't know what else to tell you. I hate it here. The chasm scene is like the most beautiful scene ever written in literature. I mean, you can quote me on that. I'm not taking any rebuttals at this point in time. Thank you. I feel like that's enough. But like, I don't want Shallan and Kaladin to be together either. But like, I feel like if I had to choose, if like the three of them couldn't be together, I don't know. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna leave. Question number four is a genre that you never go for. And I think the one that I would definitely say that I never tend to go for is YA contemporary. High school wasn't really fun for me, like it was fine. And I don't really want to revisit that for some reason. I just never want to read about high school kids figuring things out. I mean, I have on occasion read and liked a few, but like, it's not something I actively want to pick up. If I am in the mood for a contemporary, I usually go for anything, historical romances, historical mysteries, or I go for an adult contemporary, but I never go for the YA contemporaries, if that makes sense. A popular or beloved character that you do not like. I think this is the one question that is the same as like when I filmed this tag like a year ago, because I really couldn't think of anyone that I hated as much as I hate this one person. But I mean, because usually I either am obsessed with characters or I couldn't care less about them, but I never really hate them, if that makes sense. So the character I hate more than anything in the world is Aiden, that guy, the guy whose name is basically Aiden, but like fancier, the one with the blonde hair and like, you know, annoying attitude, that one. Oh my God, I hate him so much. I haven't read these books in like 2 years. He's in the Throne of Glass, by the way. Hate him so much. Like, especially in like the last two books, oh my God, he was so annoying. Literally, Aiden can go sit on a cactus. I don't like him. Okay, I could not tell you why because I haven't read these books in so long. But also, by the time I got to like book 6 or even book 5, let's say, in Throne of Glass, I didn't care about anyone at that point. I like Lysandra and I loved Elite and Lorcan. I still like them. But other than that, I didn't care about the story. I think I'd just grown out of love with that series. But I needed to read just to know what happened to Elite and Lorcan. And wow, Aiden got on my nerves. I hated him so much. Like this is how much I hate him. I can't tell you why I hate him. Just like everything he did in like those last two books literally made me roll my eyes. I hate him. I think Lysandra deserved better. I think his father deserved better. I hate him. A popular author that you can't seem to get into? Neil Gaiman, I guess. I've read the Graveyard book and I've read Stardust and I didn't like either of them too much. Also Patrick Ness. I don't think I've ever finished a book of his because they're all chunkers and I just can't get into his writing style. I read the first book, The Knife of Never Letting Go, I think. And then I read More of Us, More Than Us, something like that one. I don't know. I'm not saying I'll never pick up any of their books ever again, but also I just have never felt the need. I feel like if I ever pick up a book by Neil Gaiman, it'll be Good Omens, just because I have to finish that TV show, but I also love that TV show. And I don't know, I feel like if I ever pick up a book, if I ever feel the need, I'll pick up that one. A popular book trope that you're tired of seeing. So like The Lost Princess, The Corrupt Ruler, love triangles. I guess, I mean, we can say insta-love. We can also say, I don't know, I feel like I'm not very particular about tropes as long as like they're done well. So like the execution of the trope is more important than anything. But like this one trope that a surprising amount of YA books do that I literally, it boils my blood. I hate it so much. I don't think anyone ever talks about it just because it's so vague and random. It's basically one-upping pain. I hate it. What that basically is that two characters are having a confrontation and one of them says, oh, my parents were abusive to me as a kid. And the second person is like, well, at least you had parents. And the first guy's like, whoa, you're right, your problems are bigger than mine. I can't complain. No, I hate it so much. Like, just because someone has different problems from you that seem more drastic doesn't mean that your problems are negated, doesn't mean your pain is negated. I hate it so much. And so many characters do this, like so many books, like they just randomly pull this up. And I don't know why you can't have a conversation about your pain. Like, it's fine, you don't have to fight over who's more in pain. I don't know. So that's my answer. A popular series that you have no interest in reading. I had to go and scroll through my Goodreads because I'm like a serial series finisher. So even if I hate a series, I will read it till the end. Eventually, like I won't get to it like right away, but I wouldn't give up on it. But then I realized that one of the only books that I've ever DNF'd is part of a series, and it's YA contemporary. Oops. It's American Royals. I get secondhand everything really easily, so like secondhand embarrassment, secondhand like anxiety, so much secondhand anxiety. So like this book was actually stressful to read because people were just being horrible. It was one of those books like Gossip Girl, I guess. It's something that a lot of people love, but it's just something that I don't like watching because I don't know, people pretending to be friends with you and then like backstabbing you behind your back. Obviously that's what backstabbing is, whatever. Just that book stressed me out, so I read half of it and then I was like, no, I'm just gonna skip to the end and see how this goes and if it's worth reading. It wasn't. I know a lot of people love this book because it's like Gossip Girl but like with royalty. I'm not gonna read it. Like, the second book just came out, or like is gonna come out soon. Maybe if the whole series is over and I can read how the book ends. No, see, like, I don't know, it's just not my kind of book, so I'm not gonna keep reading it. Another one is like, I really wanted to try out Tamara Pierce because I feel like she's like a classic fantasy YA author. So I tried her newest book, Tempest and Slaughter. I hated it. It was so boring. Sorry. I feel like so many people are gasping. So many people love her. So, but I don't think anyone really talks about this series. I feel like they talk about her quartet of books. Yeah, no one really talks about the series, but I picked it up because it was a school setting and I was like, yes, please give me all the school settings. And it was very like, I don't know, it just, it was boring. The magic was cool, like the learning magic element was really cool, but everything else, I feel like maybe I shouldn't have started with that book because it was like book 9 in the Temeraire whatever world, but like the first book in that series, I don't know. But like, I'm not gonna read 16 books just to read that one book that I didn't like. The last question is, the saying goes, the book is always better than the movie, but what movie/TV adaptation do you prefer more than the book? So for the longest time, my answer for this was always The Chronicles of Narnia. I grew up on those movies. I watched them like religiously throughout my childhood, especially the first one and Prince Caspian because Ben Barnes. And then I finally read The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe for a children's lit class last year, and it felt like I was reading the movie screenplay, which I guess is great, but I just felt like because I'd seen the movie and I'd loved the movie so much, like the book was pretty okay in comparison. But my answers changed because I still didn't mind the book, I just liked the movie better. But my new answer is Stardust by Gil Gaiman. Wow, this movie literally hurt me and like my heart like blossomed into a freaking flower. I loved it so much. Yeah, like I said before, I didn't really like Stardust. I was bored for most of it and the movie was so good. Maybe because I was watching it and like talking to Katie and Nicole on Discord, that was why it was so much fun. But also I just love that movie. It's so magical and fun, and like I feel like it's similar to the book but it's so much better on screen than it was in book form. Is that it? Okay, so that is this tag. I feel like everyone who's ever wanted to do this tag has done this tag, but if you haven't, I tag you. I would love to see your answers. Like I said, I love this tag, so let me know if you're doing it. Yeah, that is all I have for this video. All my links are down below, as well as the subscribe button, and I will see you guys in my next video. Goodbye.